What's going on, my ASVAB party people? Coach Anderson here, and I know how annoying it is to deal with equations that can look confusing. So if you check this out over here, it's easy to see that, hey, these look similar, but they're a little different. And what I'm going to show you in this video is the difference between them, how to use your fundamentals to solve this the right way, and clear that confusion. That way you can raise that score. So don't forget to hit like and subscribe, but let's dive in. Here are the solutions to both of these problems. All right, let's dive in. Timer's out of the way. Let's zoom on in for number one and let's get to work. So, who here felt like number one tripped them up? Who here felt like number one was a little confusing, a little annoying? Okay. No worries. Again, it's okay. It's completely okay to feel like something is a little out of our range. It's all good. Now, the more important thing is, let's see if we can guide ourselves to the right answer using those principles. So, everybody, help me out. Pop quiz. Fill in the blank. Solving equations is the art of what? Solving equations is the art of, yes, working backwards. Solving equations is the art of working backwards. So, when we take a look, what does working backwards mean? It means understanding what the forward steps would be so that we can move backwards. So over here, the forward steps, if I knew what m was, if I knew what the variable was, everybody, what would come first? If I knew what m was, would I subtract the 5 first? Would I divide by 9 first? Which one would it be? Yeah, division. Division is what's coming first. Take a look. Take a look. I would divide by 9 first, then I would subtract by 5. Do we see, before I continue, do we see what the forward step is here? Again, if I knew what m was, I would first divide by 9. Then you see that that minus 5 is separate. That minus 5 is attached there after the fact. Booyah. So once we get that understanding down, that's gonna make everything else so much easier. So much easier. So look, now that we know, we can begin by adding 5 to both sides because we know that that would have been the last step, minus 5. So now we can add 5. Now that we did that, booyah cancels out on the right side, giving us 2 equals m divided by 9. We get 2 because if you owe $3 and you then pay $5, well, now you have 2 surplus. Or you can think about it as 5 minus 3, which is still gonna be 2, whatever way you wanna look at it, but there you go. I think for most of us, the big light bulb moment came right here, understanding what order we're going in. So now that we know that, and we're at the second step here, the last step, oh, super easy. Barely an inconvenience, multiply by 9 on both sides, and we are good. Boom, we get m by itself, and that's gonna be m equals 18. Thus, the answer is A. So look at that. Adiel, you said, oh wow, it's so simple. But everybody, would it be agreeable to you if we said that, yeah, this is simple if we know the order of operations, if we commit to the strategy? Yeah, that's the point I've been trying to make this entire time, and I'm glad that more and more and more of us are really coming to adopt that and accept that idea. So that's what it's all about, everybody. This is how you can look at any equation and feel comfortable with knowing how to solve it. Again, this is linear equations specifically. So let's take a look at number two. We have a negative 10 plus n, all of that divided by 10. Look at how this is different. Notice how the negative 10 plus n, that's all together up top, and we're dividing all of that by 10. So boom, there's our last step right there. We're dividing the entire thing by 10. So the opposite of that would be multiplying everything by 10 on both sides. So once we do that, booyah cancels out, leaving us with negative 10 plus n equals 1 times 10, which is 10. Now that we're here, the next step that we'll take will be to get rid of that negative 10. And again, that 10, that negative 10 that's just sitting there, we can treat that as subtracting 10 or minus 10. So the opposite of that would be adding 10 to both sides, and we are done. Cancels out on the left side, leaving us with n equals 20. And there we go. And our answer here is C. And there we go. Boom. There's number one. And number two, there we go. So this is where, you know, this is the point of class where we should definitely be feeling a difference between where we were all these problems ago, all the way back here. We should be feeling a good difference between starting all the way back here, doing these, and then doing these sets of practice so far. We should feel a huge difference. And if you are feeling any sort of difference at all, I'm glad. I'm really happy. If we're still feeling like we're confused, it might probably be because of the negatives that we've been dealing with, the negative numbers specifically. So remember, you have that responsibility of continuing to push forward in the right direction by understanding that if you're not quite comfortable with your fundamentals, get comfortable with those fundamentals. Put that practice in. And before you move on, my party people, I appreciate you watching the video, but if you want more, I offer a free class once a week. Why not join? Again, it's free, 2 hours a week. That way you can continue raising your score and get the job you want. So with that said, feel free to text me about the free registration or go to our website to sign up, show up, and raise your score. I'll see you there, my Porter people. Cheers.